out of Busta Rhymes. And Differentology on 1X, it's 12:40 right now. So, Sarah Jane Crawford is up next at 1 o'clock with her revision of history, she says. Pacific. Her smash. 7 on 3 of 3, where you choose to choose. Well, I've got Charlie Sloth and Charlie Lowe in the studio. Next track is Puff Daddy Big Homie. Till 9 is DJ Target Infamous. And it's Jam Hart and the mix at 6. Bishop Nehru. I'll play what he wants to play, 9 till 10. Picking the music, giving a chance to find out what influenced him as well. In Israel. And at 10 o'clock, it's Robbo Rhymes with the Dinosaur Show, Dancehall Top 5, and extra talent DJ Corey. Tonight, 2 till 4, it's Toddler T. Ross talks chicken wings, Jamaica, and strippers. Obviously, he's a decorator. Alright, so that's all coming up. And you know what? I've dug something up. I thought it'd be really haven't heard it in a long, long time. It's a Live Lounge Reload BP, and this is his version of Kanye West's Sunlight.
Good shot, nice,
George,
nice.
Tomorrow, join us on the show for the afternoon from Illmatic. Of course, it's Good Friday tomorrow, isn't it? Hey, a lot of people off work. Yeah. We're not. We're happy to be here. We'll entertain you on Good Friday. Make sure you join me on 10. Jen Crawford is up after the news. Join her too. And all day long.
Listen, watch, share. Team Radio, one extra.
When most people take their driving test, they probably think they'll never have to take it.
I've always been sort of like, I've always wanted to. I always like cars.
But for the first time, Newsweek reveals how around 200 new drivers are licenses taken away.
And it's like, oh, okay.
New drivers, you know, once they've passed that test, you're an expert, does it?
Mum, this might be my last chance to say I love you. The final word sent by a text from a student on board the sinking It sounds not unconfirmed, but hundreds remain missing. Takeaways accused of food.
It wasn't just lamb, the lamb dish you ordered. So that means there could have been.
In sport, it's 3 points on the pitch for Crystal Palace, but a round of Scots go away. Mike is here with the details. Has had inside knowledge of their starting lineup before their 3-0 home defeat earlier this month. The result shouldn't stand. We'll explain all in the next 15 minutes.
This
Newsbeat.
Around 200 new drivers are having their away every week. Newsbeat has got hold of the showing the number of people clocking up 6 penalties within 2 years of passing their test. This is driving without insurance. Declan Harvey has the story.
You a Taylor Swift fan? I didn't expect you to say that, Chris. I expected you to say
that. Taylor Swift fan, I've got the songs.
He's showing us around South End in Essex. He's lived here his whole life.
I'm South End here. And they just wanted them to say, he's the parking there. It's
what he says. He's off the fridge.
After passing his test, his dad policy, meaning Chris couldn't. Chris didn't realise he wasn't covered to drive any other vehicle.
Come up to the roundabout, the person in front of me hesitated at the roundabout. She couldn't go, she didn't. But someone looked up, looked on bumpers.
He wasn't insured in the car he borrowed, but only found that out when he handed his documents in at a police station.
And it was like, oh, okay, she tortured me on the spot.
And so Chris became one of the thousands of new drivers to have their license revoked every year. In 2012, it was more than 200 a week. A Freedom of Information request by Newsweek has revealed 54% of those who lost their license had been driving without insurance. Speeding was the second most common cause, while more than 800 people in total got 6 points for driving while distracted. We asked Scott Pendry at the Association of British Insurers why the percentage for uninsured drivers was so high.
That's due primarily down to advances into technology. Those people who are driving uninsured are being identified in a much better way, so that they're not on the central database that shows that they are insured. They will face severe ramifications.
On the Newsweek website, you can see how many people got points for drink driving.
Hello, I'm Gary from Brake, the road safety charity. New drivers, you know, once they've passed that test, doesn't make them expert, does it? I think better training, better education, graduated introduction to a sort of, if you like, qualified license. I think all of that.
Well, people like Chris and Southend, having their license revoked made them safer drivers. Natasha contacted us on Facebook from the Scottish Borders. She has 5 points, so it's very close to being revoked after she bumped a car in a car park. She panicked and drove off. And she says it's better to punish new drivers for simple mistakes. Greg, agree?
Frankly, no. Natasha, everybody needs to know what the law is. Enjoy the motoring, but be safe.
Well, Jamie has tweeted us on this. The price of insurance for a new driver, it's scandalous. Not an excuse to drive without any, though, he adds. Tell us your experiences with at BBC Newsbeat.
Newsbeat.
Every second is critical. The warning from South Korea's president. The search for survivors from a sunken ferry goes on. 300 people, most of them high school students. Families desperate for news have been waiting for updates. Texts sent by students as the ferry sunk was one saying, "Mum, this is my last chance to tell you I love you." Why? Replied. G-Day Jin's 8-year-old nephew. 79 people rescued.
Knows is that his mom and dad and brother is still on the boat. I don't think he realizes the consequences that they might have.
A small part of the ship's hull can now be seen poking above the water. It's surrounded by thousands of ships and aircraft working against high winds and strong currents.
U.S. Navy Lieutenant Arlo says they're still hopeful.
Each one of these search and rescue operations is uniquely difficult, and obviously you know the conditions that are out there that make it difficult.
We don't know why the ferry sunk yet. Police are questioning the captain. He's appeared on television and apologized. And deeply ashamed, he said, I don't know what to say. In the Premier League last night, but on both ends of the table, into the penalty area. We'll have all the details for one. In the rest of the investigation, a 19-year-old girl was seriously burnt when she opened her door to a gang who threw cleaning fluid over her. CCTV showed four men, all thought to be in their late teens, away from the house in Tiverdale. Officers say they believe it was a targeted attack. A lorry driver has been arrested over a crash which killed two people on the M26 in Kent yesterday morning. A 16-year-old girl and 22-year-old woman, both from France, died in the accident. The Russian President Vladimir Putin has been on television accusing Ukraine of committing a crime by using military force against civilians in the east of the country. He said he hoped it wouldn't have to send troops in to protect Russian-speaking communities there. It comes as high-level international talks on the crisis take place in Geneva. In Argentina, a 15-year-old girl who was kept hostage in a garage for 9 years by her foster parents has been rescued by police. She was kept with a dog and a monkey and beaten with a belt if she tried to eat food which was given to the pet. Two people have been charged with slavery and abuse.
Newsbeat.
The director of the latest X-Men movie has been accused of drugging and raping a teenage boy. According to a loose lawsuit filed in the US, Bryan Singer used his influence as a Hollywood insider to force his 17-year-old victim to have sex. Newsbeat's entertainment reporter, Chi-Chi, has more.
Future past hit cinemas in the UK at the end of May. Promotional tour, but in the space, the lawsuits involving producer-director Bryan Singer are threatening to overshadow the movie's release. 31-year-old Michael Egan says Bryan met him in the late 1990s during some house parties in California and Hawaii in a series of lawsuits. Michael, who's seeking financial damages, said he was going in private jets to attractive locations where he was supplied with drugs and alcohol at 17. Bryan's lawyer says the legal action is absurd and defamatory.
Takeaways are facing tougher tests on lamb dishes. Are cracking down after two different studies found dishes advertised as lamb actually contained other Stephen Powell has more on this one.
You know the feeling? You come to the end of a long, hard week and you fancy out in front of the TV with a takeaway. Lamb kebab, anyone?
It wasn't just in the lamb dish you ordered. So that means there could have been chicken or beef, and in the cases, there was no lamb at all.
They tested 60 dishes in London and Birmingham, and 50% contained meat other than lamb.
Shockingly, we did find we couldn't really identify what the meat was.
In a separate standards agency found that 45 samples taken had a variety of meat in them, and some no lamb at all. So
when you get
tied
up so cheap, you don't really know what kind of meat you get in.
If it said it's lamb, it should be lamb, shouldn't it?
I suppose it would, especially with the horse food scandal and all that as well.
I guess if you're we'd like to think that it's what you ordered,
really. Half expensive. It's an expensive one. No traces of horse meat were found in any of these studies, but councils are now being hundreds of samples of lamb in their area as a priority. Take away
the
food, label their food, and face fines of $1,000.
It's really important that we know where our food is coming from and exactly what it is.
So he's been described in the press as the Mad Muller and Captain Hook. Now, the rabbi teacher Abu Hamza, who's been 10 years in the British jail for spreading racism, is going on trial in the States. Newsbeat will begin being released him later. Newsbeat's Tamsin is following this and is here now. So, Tamsin, first of all,
Muslim
priest
in the UK.
Let's go! Big shots, come on! Go on, George! Big shots! Big shots!
Challenges he's facing relate to his apparent links to Al Qaeda, don't they?
Yes, specifically to his support of the group, to hostage taking and setting up.
Forward.
So yeah, good luck to him. Play that for you as well. Still to come on the show. Well, you can loads of great tracks, but first some Isle of Lamb.
Some coach.
Gemma at the moment. Gas pedal. Bike pedal. Swim across the way as well. Let's do my little push pedal. And an old school classic in the form of CLC. That's all on the way. You can get in touch with me. At One Extra. Double A triple one, let us know what you're up to. Shout out to everybody tuned in right now, Sarah Jane Crawford on your radio, with you till 4 p.m.
I'm just trying to make it clear where I'm a great man. Well, I'm safe. No money on my mind. First of May.
Session's getting hard, not easier. You have to stand down here. Get too old.